Hello students, today we are going to learn coming to the next topic. It is dealing with the superficial deposits and its geological importance. Let us see what do you mean by superficial deposits and how they are important to geology. What do you mean by superficial deposits? They are nothing but sometimes they are called as drift. Okay. They are nothing but the youngest geological deposits which are formed in the most recent period of geological time, that is Quaternary. What do you mean by Quaternary? Which extends back about or before 2.6 million years ago. 2.6 million years ago. Or from present 2.6 million years back. Okay. Actually, they rest on older deposits or rocks. Generally, these are referred as bedrocks. We have already seen in the previous slides what do you mean by bedrocks in the refraction and reflection lesson. Yes. Here, they also refer to the geological deposits which are typically of Quaternary age. Again, I told you less than 2.6 million years old or from present 2.6 million years ago. Also, all these deposits are referred as bedrocks. Yes. Okay. So what happens is these geologically recent and consolidated sediments also sometimes include stream channel and floodplain deposits, beach sands, talus gravels, and glacial drift and moraine. Okay. Also, these are very important. Let me repeat. What are all included? Stream channel. Stream channel, floodplain deposits, beach sands, talus gravels, glacial drifts, and moraine. These are all the things which are included in the unconsolidated sediments. Okay. Coming to the deposits, again, they are naturally occurring and their origin is natural and also in place, which are held in the superficial deposits theme. Okay. Also, this superficial strata will be held in the mass movement theme. This mass is moved from one place to another, or in the artificial ground theme, where they are of human origin. Here, the human origin will take place, like on the surface of the earth. What does the superficial deposits have the geological importance? They are generally recorded only on onshore and around the coast, where they are laid down by various natural processes like ice, water, wind, glaciers. Okay, ice, water, wind, sometimes by glaciers also. But more recently, offshore deposits have also been mapped and they are held in the separate seabed sediments theme. Okay. So sometimes these deposits are unconsolidated sediments like gravel, sand, silt and clay. Also onshore, they are formed relatively thin and also they are discontinuous patches or large spreads in structure. Almost all these deposits are classified on the basis of their origin or the mode of origin with the names such as glacier deposits, like they are formed with the help of glaciers, river terrace deposits with the river or blown sand, or their composition such as peat. Recently, some of them have been given formal names such as loess spot formation. Okay, so coming to the superficial deposits, here a very important point to note is almost all these deposits are formally classified on the basis of mainly in their mode of origin, such as glacier deposits, which are formed with respect to the glaciers, and river terrace deposits, which are formed with the help of the river, and blown sand, which are formed with respect to the sand, or there are sometimes referred with the help of the composition, such as peat. So, recently some of them have been also given the formal name, such as Loess formation. So these are all some of the superficial deposits which are mainly classified with the help of their mode of origin and also composition. Thank you.